if my child died, I would want to cry my eyes out. I don't think I would. Sociopaths don't form normal emotional attachments to other people. They lack empathy. When they see a person suffering, they don't feel bad over it. I was in high school biology when evolutionary theory was really laid out for us. Species develop new characteristics, new traits, and then those can actually eventually take over. And so I concluded that maybe I had reached a higher stage of humanity where I wasn't held back by emotions the way other people were. And so I came to regard all these little rules that people tell you to follow as kind of brainwashing me. Breaking into places and, you know, breaking into the school or stealing things. I felt like I was stripping away these layers of rules that people had been imposing on me my entire life, and it was an amazing feeling. And if I really wanted to sort of be free of everything I've been brainwashed into thinking about right and wrong, and I decided to kill my dad. And I decided to do it in a brutal fashion, not a gunshot or anything. I was going to do it with a hammer. When I walked up to my dad, I had a hammer in my hand, and I hit him in the head 7 or 8 times with a ball-peen hammer until I thought he was dead, and I just left. One of his friends, Jim, found him, covered in blood, took him to a hospital, and so I went and told my mom, hey, I may have done this, because I think I'm being told on at that moment. I mean, instead of taking me to the police or anything, she took me to a psychiatric hospital. They made a report based on the time that I was there, and it said antisocial personality disorder. Eventually, Virginia had them remove me from the psychiatric hospital and take me to jail. Since my dad survived, I was convicted of malicious wounding. I was sentenced to 10 years in prison. There was a Christian named Randy, and he was a bit different from everyone else. And one day he was reading his Bible, and I walked up to him and I said, hey, you know why you're reading your Bible? You're reading your Bible because you're born in the United States. If you'd been born in China, you'd be a Buddhist. If you'd been born in India, you'd be a Hindu. If you'd been born in Saudi Arabia, you'd be a Muslim, because people like you believe whatever you're taught to believe. He started arguing with me and started tearing me to pieces. And that was very different from other Christians that I'd argued with in the past. I ended up in, for a couple of months, a series of arguments with Randy about Christianity versus my worldview. Randy was winning the arguments that we would get into. I'm not gonna beat him this way. I'm gonna have to really learn the Bible so that I can respond to him. I regarded that as my weakness. I have to say I was impressed with Jesus. I went from thinking that I'm the best person in the world to thinking that I'm the worst person in the world. The question came up, either I'm stuck like this, or there's someone out there who can deal with this. Who, out of anyone, had the ability to change, radically change, severely messed up people? It's Jesus or it's nothing. It's Jesus or there is just no hope. I bowed down and I prayed and I said, God, I don't know if I'm going to believe in you tomorrow, but I believe in you right now. If you can do anything with me, you're welcome to it. And I ran through the sort of sinner's prayer that I'd heard there in the jail. When I sat up, the whole world looked different. It looked like I was in a different place, like everything was a different color. And I didn't know if this was, you know, just something weird going on, but it was, I didn't want to hurt anyone at that point. And an amazing calm. I felt like I'd been physically nonstop brawling all my life, and that I finally could just sit down and rest. While I was in prison, I thought it would be bad to actually confess, because my dad, again, had no recollection. I'm a Christian now. I can't spend my entire life saying I haven't done something that I've done. I'm going to write a letter to my dad right now and lay everything out to him. He came to see me at the first chance, and he said, it's okay, and he forgives me. And he told me, he said, I really didn't think you did it. And so for him to hear all of that at once and then to forgive me, it's amazing stuff. Between jail and prison, I was locked up for a little over 5 years. I got out of prison in 2000 and started college immediately. Started arguing with a young woman who was an agnostic, and she eventually became a Christian, and we were married the following year. We have kids, and you know, getting to watch them grow up, and given the things I've done, I should not be able to have this sort of normal life. It kind of blows me away. I want people out there to know that there is a creator to this world, that there is a point to this world, that other people are important, that it's not just all about you. Jesus rose from the dead, and that shows that there is a point to everything, that there is a creator, that he does care about us, and that he entered this world to die for us. And that is a message that matters because it changes everything.